Outpainting is a terrific way to expand the borders of any image using a diffusion model. Here's how you can do it in ComfyUI. So first up, I'm going to go ahead and load an image. I just am going to double click and then find load image. And here's an image that I downloaded earlier from Unsplash. And I'm going to go ahead and connect this to the pad image for Outpainting node. So I'm going to take this and put it to the input here. And basically what I want to do is expand the top of this image by 400 pixels. And I'm going to set the feathering value to 200. This helps kind of soften the lines between this newly generated image that we're going to be creating on top compared to the image that we currently have. And then I'm going to go ahead and drag this image output and then connect it to this VAE encode for inpainting. And then go ahead and connect the VAE value from our checkpoint along with the mask here. And then this output, we're just going to go ahead and bring it directly to the KSampler for the latent image input. So I just want to briefly talk on a few other of these options here before we process the image. So first up, you're going to want to make sure that you use an inpainting model. This is trained on partial images and does a great job at whenever it comes to outpainting. As far as the prompt for both the negative and the positive prompts, you want to kind of balance what the image currently is and where you want it to go. So here's my prompt that I have here, but I added in special modifiers here like looking at viewer and brown hair. As while they aren't evident in this current image, I would like for them to be evident in the expanded or outpainted image. Now, as far as the KSampler values, I'm using a fixed seed value just for testing here, and I set the sampler and scheduler to what works best for this model. So you always want to check what model you're using and what the recommended settings are. And the denoise value is going to be at 1. And then I'm going to go ahead and just create a preview of this image and then cue prompt. So here's our output image. As you can see, it did a great job of creating a consistent image based on what the input value was provided. I hope that this video was helpful. If it was, please consider hitting that thumbs up. If you have any questions about the workflow, please drop a line in the comments below. Lastly, a workflow is included in the description if you want to go ahead and download it and test it out on your machine. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.